Did you hear the news? I'm done. Code Interpreter is the nail in the coffin for me. Jobs are gonna be gone tomorrow. Going to paradise. Okay, why not educate yourself on it rather than running away from it? I'm sure we have all felt like that at some point. Other Tiff, can I call you?
Okay, I guess I'll stay around for a little bit.
But then I'm gone. But the reality is there is so much more to it than, oh my gosh, this is going to take over my job. And we're going to get into what exactly does this mean for software developers, for data analysts, data scientists, many different roles within the tech industry later in this video. But first, let's actually get our hands in it. Let's see what is this thing actually capable of and what is just the hype about. Also too, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech, coding, and career related content. All right, let's get into it. All right, well, first of all, what are the current capabilities of Code Interpreter? Well, to start with, it is only familiarized, or it only is sufficient in Python. It does not know or familiarize itself with JavaScript yet or any other programming language, but the keyword is yet. That is to come. For now though, with Python, what it is really good at doing is reading and analyzing big data sets. And we're gonna get into that. And I think the main thing, it's funny because Code Interpreter, you would think it would be used for web developers, or that's the tool that it would be mainly primarily focused on writing code, building websites, but in turn, it's actually really good at analyzing data of this moment or at this moment. But in turn, at this current moment, it actually focuses more on data. If you upload a CSV file and then it can turn this into these really detailed graphs, explain to you what is going on, make GIFs for you out of, you know what, let me show you. All right, to start with, I have up on screen here ChatGPT, and you can see under GPT-4, I have Code Interpreter. Now, I am a subscriber plus. If you are not, you won't be able to see Code Interpreter or use it at this moment. It will come though, it's just slowly being rolled out. What I didn't realize though at first is because this is beta, when you initially, if you are a paid subscriber, when you initially go to ChatGPT-4 or GPT-4, Code Interpreter will not be there. What you need to do actually is go into your settings and ensure under beta that Code Interpreter is toggled on. That way, then when you go to use it or use GPT-4, you will see it there. All right, so before we do anything else though, we need to get a big data set. So let's go to Kaggle.com and find a data set that we can start analyzing. We, meaning Code Interpreter. Okay, so you can see on screen here, I have Kaggle.com up, and this is a great website. Whenever you wanna build with data, for this, I went to data sets. And you can see here there's trending, sports, a ton of different ones to choose from. I actually am gonna go back because I chose one I wanna really focus on, which is sleep, health, and lifestyle data set. And this is interesting because essentially it is a data set that comprises of 400 rows and 13 columns covering a wide range of variables related to sleep and daily habits. So gender, age, occupation. So you can really get a good sense, or the goal we will be using this data for is to get a good sense of who has the best sleep, what lifestyle factors are with that best sleep, and see hopefully if we can replicate it, because sometimes I don't get that good of a sleep. That's why I drink so much coffee. So to take this, let's go download, and we do have to sign in or create an account. So let's go ahead and do that. I'll be right back.
2 hours later.
All right, 20 years later, we are back. I hate that you have to create a password for everything. And I just downloaded the file, the sleep CSV. So now back in ChatGPT, let's make sure Code Interpreter is toggled, which it is. Interpreter. Yeah, okay. Now that we've got that out of the way, let's upload our CSV file. Let's go into downloads and go to sleep dataset. We could just press enter and see it work its magic, but let's just to get a little bit more detailed, let's go explain this data set to me in simple terms. All right, let's see how it does. Now, while it's explaining and writing its explanation for us, something really interesting that I like is you can click on show work and it will show how it got to its explanation, which is really interesting, especially for individuals who are data nerds or really that's their world, to understand, okay, why, what, okay, there was males, the ages, occupation, sleep duration. And now if we scroll down here, it will say the data set appears to be a collection of personal health and lifestyle data. Okay, as expected. And then it goes into what each column represents. So it breaks down from person, gender, age. And then also too, it does kind of a nice summary. In simple terms, the data set seems to be examining the relationship between various lifestyle factors. All right, let's get into it a little bit further now. Let's start actually building graphs with it, and seeing what it's capable of. Let's try seeing what some of the trends are. That's the goal of this for this sleep lifestyle, what makes people have good sleep. So let's go. Can you share with me what are some of the trends in this data? And I'm hoping it will return for me a graph as well, but if it doesn't, we will prompt it to. So let's see what it returns. I don't think you can, but if you listen ever so closely, you might be able to hear Mr. Mug snoring in the background. For me, I can hear it a lot, but I think if it's in the next room, you might not be able to. 12 p.m. on a Sunday, just having a nap. I was gonna say cat nap, but he would not like that. Dog nap. All right, based on the basic summary statistics of the data set, here are some initial trends. All right, you know what? This is a lot of text. Let's let it finish, and then we'll ask it to put this into a graph for us. And let's focus on in the graph. Should we just get it to do it all and see what happens? Okay, it says this here actually. For a more detailed analysis, we could examine the correlations between variables, distribution of variables. For example, we could look how sleep duration varies with physical activity. Let's do that. Plot for me how, create a graph for me with the, with a detailed analysis, let's use its words, to examine the correlation between how sleep duration varies with physical activity level. Now let's see this graph come into play. I mean, that's where the fun part is. It can create so many interesting graphs. I think that's what gets people excited, really. All right, this is pretty cool. Look at this detailed graph it did. This is legit, I'm telling you. And it also too explains the graph, shows its work. This is like, you know when you're in school and they're like, show your work that you did to get to this answer. This is what that is doing right now. So let's see. The scatter plot above shows a correlation between physical activity and sleep, okay? We can see a positive correlation between physical activity level and sleep duration. Yeah, I'm not surprised. The level of physical activity increases, the sleep duration increases as well. So we see here, sleep duration in hours. So we go to say 8, and then as the physical activity level goes up in time spent on it, it correlates to amount of time slept. So this is pretty cool. This is a small example showing about how you can really, analyze your sleep or whatnot. Like imagine if you had a Oura ring or anything else really, and you wanted to have a better understanding of the data behind your health, or maybe you're doing something for a job interview. I'm using health as an example, but this could be used for anything. Actually, you know what? Let's go through some other examples. Okay, I just found this really cool article on Medium I want to take you through because there are some examples that I have yet to see being posted on the internet. So let's scroll down a little bit. 10 mind-blowing use cases. I'll link this article down below because I'm not going to go through them all, but SM Rayan, thank you for this. All right, so easily create all kinds of graphs. We've seen this, we know what this is about. Pretty cool though still, of course, and gonna be really very helpful for a lot of data analysts out there. All right, convert any GIF into an MP4. I mean, I've seen this one before, pretty cool though. Let's see if we open up Twitter here, upload a GIF, and then it will turn into a dramatic slow zoom in effect. Ah, we're not logged into Twitter. I'm on Threads, I'm not on Twitter, but you can kind of see it there. Well, I am on Twitter, but I don't really use it. Okay, so then this one I found to be really cool. This is you can extract the colors from an image to create a simple PNG palette. That's pretty wild. So what you can do is upload an image. So let's say a PNG, and it will, actually, you know what? Let's just watch this. I watched this already and I want to share it with you. Let's go here, play. Create a script that extracts the top 5 colors from a picture and then makes it into a PNG. All right, so they're gonna upload an image here. And then it's gonna create a new palette image, new PNG with the palette. This is wild, let's see. Working, showing its work. Come on, I wanna see the result. Updating the script, extracting the top colors. Can you display the palette PNG now? Okay. This is worth it, I promise you. I know it takes a bit. This is crazy. This is so cool. There is the color palette that was generated from that image. So this is, it's getting pretty wild out here. And I won't be super cliche and sound like everyone else when we start talking about this, but this is not gonna take over your job. It's gonna take over jobs of people who don't embrace this technology. I know, if I had a dollar for every time someone told me that, I'd be like, barf, I'm done. I'm so tired of people here saying this, like, come up with your own original answer about how AI will affect our jobs. But it's really true. This technology will be used a ton, maybe not in the form of ChatGPT. I know that's the plugin that we were using right now, but as it continues to expand, you can think about how the technology behind Code Interpreter could be used, or there's talks about it already, articles online saying it could be used with, say, GitHub Copilot, or different kind of AI tools that help us code better, and what does that look like? And it's one of those things that it's not going to overtake our jobs. We are so far away from that. And I always say, when that point comes that jobs are overtaken, we're all gonna be doomed, not just programmers, not just people in tech, either doomed or living on a beach, like the Tiff earlier was trying to get to. But at the end of the day, I would highly suggest you check this out, start utilizing it and playing around with it, seeing how you can build with it, because I really think the opposite. If you are able to build some really interesting things with this, it will really make you stand out to future employers on your resume, showing you are embracing technology rather than being scared of it. Should we do like this? I was gonna do mugs. All right, someone got to listen to me talk today, and it was this one. I hope you found the conversation more interesting than he did, because he didn't seem to really care about it at all. Anyways, hit that subscribe button for more tech, coding, career-related content, and all right, I'll see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.